Hey everybody, it's Richard RMAutodiag here, and today we're going to be talking about bulbs. Okay, bulbs. We're going to talk a bit about them, and we're going to show you how to do a few tests on them. First, I'd like to say thank you to all my new subscribers for the support. If you're not a subscriber, then feel free to press the subscribe button down below and hit the bell for notifications. And you can make a comment if you like, if you want to get in on any conversations. Okay, there's a few different types of bulbs. The ones that we're going to be dealing with today are your standard sort of side light bulb, indicator bulbs, stuff like that, and headlight bulbs, standard headlight bulb. So the two different types is the headlight bulb is halogen, which has a mix of gases inside the glass bit there, and generally just your normal standard bulb has argon gas inside of it. Now these gases are there for different reasons. They both use a tungsten filament. I don't know if we can see that there. Let's get a pointy thing. So we've got a tungsten filament that runs just across here, just like a coiled piece of wire. And if we look on a headlight bulb, you can see it just going up and down here. Exactly the same. So the same method of testing on both. Just a little bit about it first is, if you notice on this bulb, you can see it's starting to go slightly black around the outside of the bulb. Now that's caused by when the tungsten gets heated up, which makes the light, it starts to evaporate basically, and then that tungsten then sticks to the outside of the glass there, and that's why they start going black, and they'll start getting dimmer, and eventually they'll blow. On the halogen bulbs, they don't do that, and that's pretty well down to the gas that's inside. It is a mix of gases. Funnily enough, they're called halogens, and what happens there is, when the tungsten starts to evaporate, when it gets hot, it mixes with those gases and it doesn't stick to the outside of the glass, so your bulb doesn't go black and your headlights don't get dim. Also, in this process, what happens is, because the bulb gets so hot inside, when that gas and evaporated tungsten, it sticks back to the filament and then separates itself again, so that'll give a bit of extended life because the tungsten is making its way back to the filament. Okay, so for testing standard bulb, when it's out of the car, you'll notice that you've got the metal around the outside and then there's a contact point on the bottom. When it's in the car, this outside piece here is going to be earth, and it'll be on one side of the bulb, and the contact piece in the center is where the voltage supply, your 12 volt supply, is going to come in and make the bulb light up and make the circuit. So first thing we can do is, if we get it in shot, we've got the multimeter on, we're set to ohms, so what we can do is we can make sure that the filament's intact. If we touch the outer piece here with one of the probes and the bottom contact point with the other, we should get a resistance reading. So there we go. Tiny amount of resistance there. 0.3 of an ohm. So that is intact. I'll show you a dead one here. Now on this bulb here, if I get it close enough, you can see that coiled up piece just at the front here, and it doesn't look to be broken. Usually when bulbs go, the coiled up piece goes missing, but on the bottom of a headlight bulb, we've got two contact points, and these are our connections. So we can go to one side and the other and do the same test. So one side and the other and do the same test. And you'll notice the meter still says OL. And that means that it is broken inside of here somewhere. And we're not getting a good contact, so that's not going to light up. Another type of this bulb that you can get is ones with two filaments in. If I get a bit closer, you can see there's one filament back here and then one a bit further in front. So there's one there and one up there. That's generally used for sort of a stop light and a tail light. So same procedure again. We go to the side with one, and on the bottom here you've just got a choice of two contacts. So if we go on one side, it should give us a resistance reading, which it does, 2.7 ohms. And we go to the other side and we've got 0.7 of an ohm. So those two different points there, as I say, you can see there's a difference in resistance. One of those is going to glow up brighter than the other. So your tail light is going to be the one that's not so bright, and your brake light is going to be a lot brighter for obvious reasons when you're on the road, so people know you're stopping. Another type of one that you might come across is these do come in clear as well. And the contact points on these, I don't know if you can see it, just flick it out just to show you. Right here, you see this little loop? They push up against the side of the bulb, and there's another one on the other side. So what we can do is the same, is we can touch each side of it with the probes, and we should get a resistance reading. Which we do. So we know that one's in contact as well. So that's a pretty easy way of getting around it for multimeter. What we're going to do next is we're going to put it on a battery pack and we're going to see if we can make them light. Okay, so we've got a battery pack set up here with a couple of test wires. You can do this straight to your standard car battery if you've got a couple of jumper leads or just some stripped back wires. Shouldn't make any difference. Now what we can do is we can put the negative to the outside of the bulb and just touch it there on the contact. Then we take the positive and we're going to make sure not to touch anything else apart from the contact point right at the bottom, and it should light up. There we go. And you can see that filament, when it just stops glowing there, sort of shows up quite well. What we'll do is, if we go for the one with the twin, you should see that one glows up brighter than the other. So one side, that's quite bright, and the other side, not quite so bright. Bright, not quite so bright. So in a pretty simple to test them. Again with this, if you clip it on one side and then touch it on the other, we should be able to get this little one to light up. There we go again. It's just another standard bulb, but it's just one of the orange ones for an indicator. Again, touch it on the bottom and we light up. And last of all, if you remember this one, which was our headlight bulb. Now this shouldn't work because we know that it's open circuit. So if we touch one side, touch the other, and we don't light. We're all attached there. Now on a halogen bulb, you're not supposed to touch the glass or the tip anywhere because grease off your fingers gets on them and it makes a mess. But I don't know if we can maybe tap this and see if it comes back to life. No. Sometimes when you give them a bit of a tap, if the filament's broken, it'll reattach itself and come on briefly. Okay, so last method, if you happen to have like a voltage probe, then you can use that as well. So you'd attach your two clamps to either side of the battery, and you've got your probe, and you can either give it some voltage positive, or we can give it an earth. Now, how these work is they have another wire off to the side, so that's the one that we want to touch to the side. And if we get this in shot, you'll notice when we touch it on the bottom there, it lights up to show it's making a circuit. And if we flick it up to positive, it should turn on and off, on and off. Now that this little green LED wouldn't come on if we were open circuit, so we can show that as well. If we go back to the blown bulb, if we touch it on this side, it doesn't light up because we're open circuit. So that's a good test just on its own there as well. Okay, that's a pretty good roundup of just your standard bulbs that are going to be in a car. I know we haven't touched on like your gas discharge xenon bulbs or LED bulbs. I could do something in the future about them. There's a few good little tests that we can do with them as well. Hopefully you found this pretty informative on what we did, and you can get some use out of it. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out my other videos. Cheers!